1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Stephen Ignoramus says I've got a deep and gravelly voice. It's good for checking the sound levels. 1, 2, 1, 2. One, two, one, two. I think everything's set up just fine. So, you know what? Let's play some video games. Hello, hello, everybody. Got my big cup of water here, which means I'm gonna have to pee probably before the end of the stream here. How we doing, guys? How is everybody? I don't know if anybody's even in here yet. I don't have the live chat up here. I hope there are people in here. But I'm used to playing to an empty room if I have to here. Hi, how we doing today? My name is Jay Edgar. This is Ed's World Gaming. We're going to play some more Fallout New Vegas tonight because, I mean, we've only been playing it for a fucking year at this point. So, of course we're going to sit back and play it. Oh, lost my D-Live. Let me turn the Wi-Fi on and see if that does anything. Maybe I'm just kicked off of D-Live. Who knows? Well, we're gonna try it. See you all. Welcome on in. Am I off of D-Live? Let's find out. Yep, I bumped on a D-Live for a half a second and they bumped me back off. Son of a bitch. Those assholes. Alright, I guess we're going to go no D-Live tonight. So, spread the word out. Throw it up in the Discord. I'm going to throw it in the Discord here quick before we get started here, just to let everybody know that there is no D-Live tonight. Because I'm not going to drop it and bring it back. Says my stream quality is good, so that's good. Hey, cool, I can add stuff to my browser tray. That'll make things easier. All right, let me throw an announcement up in here. I think we're going to go play some video games. Alright, we'll throw that in there, and I think we're going to get started. So, let's see what we've got here. Oh, we're losing frames. What the shit? Alright, anyway. We got to get started here, otherwise we're going to be here all night. I'm going to drop a couple things, though. Before we do that, because there's some things that I don't need to have going right now while we're doing this. And on this old, old laptop here, we are going to have to sit back and work with what we've got. It's not the best, but it'll play the video games anyway. So, all right, let's get the chat up. Let's get the performance monitor up here, and let's go see this and see how much we can piss Seawall off over the fact that I'm having tech issues. Are you guys ready? Here we go. Let's get rid of this, too. Might as well. That's lame. I was really hoping I was going to get some D-Live tonight. Aw, crap. I didn't change the scene. Alright, technical issues. Sorry. I haven't done this in a couple weeks. Yes, yes, I know what the introduction sounds like. Now let's dump this back off here so I can actually get in and get the scene up so you guys can see what the hell I'm doing here. Because you're not here to see me tonight, you're here to see the video game. Alright, let's try this again. Alright, that's up here. Take two, live chat up. Alright, let's do this again. Now I'm gonna get copyright struck for the music at the beginning. Did you know you get copyright struck for that, by the way? They have it claimed. My melee character going through Old World Blues, or not Old World Blues, I just finished Old World Blues, Dead Money right now, and just realizing what happens when you don't use a gun at all in Dead Money. It just dawned on me just a bit ago that I can't shoot off the speakers. So that's going to add a whole degree of difficulty to things, but we're going to play with this instead. I got to drop my volume here a little bit. Where were we? Where did we last leave off? I know that we finished off Benny because that was fun. Alright, so we are back up here. I just picked up. Let's do 3-card bounty first. I do believe I can't fast travel from here, though. Can I? Oh, I guess I can. Cool. We'll start from there. I don't even remember why I picked this up, to be completely honest. But I did. Alright, so the important thing to do, to think note when we're doing 3-card bounty right now, is the fact that We can't shoot him in the head. I'm gonna run out of room for shit too by the end of this. I can already see it. I'm still wearing Benny's suit too. Or I shouldn't be wearing Benny's suit, I should be wearing armor. What do I wanna use for a gun? But yes, we will be avoiding headshots at all costs, if possible. You know, I'm going to use this instead. Because we get way better rewards if we bring back an attack.
Though you aren't of the Legion, you've aided us more than once. We acquire many items on our raids, some useless to us, some forbidden. I've provided you the location of a drop box where you can obtain these items. The box will be replenished every few days. Please be aware that we'll assume any items left in the box will be unwanted and be removed and destroyed.
For how long will I get this benefit?
Stay an ally of the Legion and we will share our loot with you. If you start working against us or become an enemy, our deal ends.
Goodbye.
True to Kaiser.
That's right, because I did one of their missions. Now they think I'm their friend. Alright, let's see. I wonder if that's the Legion safe house that's up here. Let's take out Nephi. And then figure that out, because I've never been in the safe house. Because I never played a Legion chat, or a Legion character. Not that I'm playing one now, I'm playing Yes Man, but hey, as long as they're going to give me stuff for free, I'm going to take it. And then I'm still not going to feel bad when I shoot the shit out of them. We got to fix a couple things here. Let's get rid of that. Throw a little food down to see if we can take some of this weight back off. Because we are about to acquire more weight. Side of your own. What was that? I feel like you were trying to say something. Hey look, I'm over encumbered. Again. Isn't that fucking special? Yeah, I really need to offload some of this stuff. I'm carrying around way too much crap. Too bad I can't repair the Elite Riot gear with the Raider Bomber, because that would make life a lot easier. But hey, why would you want to make life easier? Especially if you've taken a perk that's supposed to do just that. I don't know. Let's go see Daughtry. Get rid of this guy. Maybe get rid of some of this inventory too, as long as we're here. Got another quest I gotta finish up at McCarran too, don't I? The listen in one that I hate. Because I can never figure out how to get it to work. all of these military trucks and none of them work. What a shame. You'd think the NCR would have had some of this shit fixed up already.
I see you're still alive, and that's promising.
I want to claim a bounty.
That right. You killed one of the psychopaths on my shit list. Let me see the scumbag's head. Well, well, well. Driver Nephi. Nothing to say, you son of a bitch. No tips on my golf swing. Lost a lot of good men to this psychopath. Morale's gonna be better now that he's gone. Here's the bounty I promised. I guess we can send First Recon down to Camp Forlorn Hope. They need all the help they can get there.
You got any more open bounties?
Damn right I do. Who do you think you can take down?
How about Violet?
Violet it is. Wish I could give you more advice on how to bring her down, but we know less about her than the other two. Just watch out for the dogs. She raises them herself. Might as well be their mother and never leave her side.
Where can I find her?
Good question. Fiend territory is southeast of here, but they range all over the area. None of them stays in any one place for long.
Anything else I need to know?
You've gone after the fiends before. I don't have to tell you to keep alert. Good luck.
All right.
Right.
Well, we'll do that one. And if we do that one, then we can do a piece of Rex's companion quest as well. And I'm going to start from here. I think. I think this is going to be the best place to start from. Because at this point, we're like right over there. What's the second marker? You haven't done shit over on this part of the map, I guess. Alright, so they are going to be over here. Where's Bonnie Springs? Right there. Don't want to do that yet. Actually, before I do this, we gotta unload some shit. I am carrying way too much stuff. As usual, I have no powder. At first, I'm going to drop some crap that I can keep. that I want to keep, but I don't necessarily want to carry it around with me everywhere. Stash that. I will hold on to the alien blaster for a little while because there, I may need to use some or use that a little bit here again. But let's go with. Let's drop the dinner bell. Let's drop the fat man. I'm gonna drop the scout rifle because the Christine's rifle is way better. I'm gonna hold on to that 9mm. Because this one's got damage 24, DPS 79. This one's got damage 29, but it's got a faster shot reload. Same thing, same ammo, but this one's a faster one, so I'm gonna. We'll drop this one off. And sell some of the rest of this shit.
You looking to buy some supplies? Can do.
I sure am. And by my... By buy, I mean get rid of some shit. We'll take those so we can make more pistol ammo. Let's see. Why don't you take that? And that, and that. And that. We'll drop that one. Have that. I don't do any drugs. There's 14 pounds that I don't need, but I can take those over to Sloan and get that done. Let's go to that though. Let's see if that did anything.
Give me a shout if you need anything else. Take it easy now.
$218, that's not so bad. Especially with all the food I'm carrying currently. Alright, let's try this again. With gusto this time. Maybe no gusto. Maybe I'll just let my companions do it all again. Seems to be working through me, or for me through this playthrough. You know what? This was way closer. Oh, why the hell I didn't do this the first time. So, if we make enemies with the Legion, which I fully intend to do at this point, they're gonna spawn over here. The assassin parties will. Wyatt, welcome on in. How we doing? How's Texas life? As you can see, I am very, very firmly planted in southern Nevada right now, so. Something for us to shoot at, that's what's going on.
Here we go.
Yeah, we'll take care of that. Down here we have some various litter here that I thought that I could loot, but apparently I can't, which is lame because that's a stealth boy right there that I want. Tin cans, beer bottles, and shit like that. And here there's a hollowed out rock that's got some ammunition. Can't touch the rest of it though. It also gives us a map marker closer to the backside of Vegas for if we want to do something like that. And over here is an irradiated gas station that's sunk into an irradiated swamp. Next to a mobile home park full of fiends who are drug lords, because stereotypes. I guess. Can't go into this gas station. But it is surrounded by a radiated pond. I wonder if I can blow this car up. Nope, I can't blow that one up. It's one of those weird things that they have on this game where it's just a random map marker. And nothing else. Take a bottle cap out of the trash can for all that rad damage. But in doing so, we're going to come into here where we've got a lot of blue blips because we have Animal Friend and one red blip.
You like the sight of your own blood?
And just like before, we'll take the leg shot to keep from the headshot so we get a complete and full head. If I'd have done a headshot, that would have been a mangled head. also going to run around here and find the named dog. Because we might have to violate Animal Friend for just a moment here. We'll have to violate the covenant of Animal Friend. Oh, I'm not doing a survival character. And my god, do I want to be doing a survival character with all this junk. Because I can build all kinds of cool shit with it. Have I put anything into survival in this playthrough? These dogs are not loyal. If I remember correctly, there is a specific one that I have to take out. Yeah, it's that one right there. And of course, it's going to turn all the rest of them on us, because why wouldn't it? But by taking this specific one out, we have Violetta's Brain, which we can use for the Rex Companion quest, and that's the reason that I came over here and did this as long as we're here. You know, as long as we're here, might as well. And done. The trailers are all blocked off. You can't go in them. All right. Another one down. Hot as hell, just got off work. I'm sorry to hear that. It's actually cooling down up here a little bit. So I don't have to run the air conditioner nonstop. I mean, I'm probably going to pop the windows open later on tonight, which I'm excited for.
Got any more good news for me?
I want to claim a bounty.
You killed another one. Let me have a look at the head. God damn it. That's Violet, all right. You've made me one happy son of a bitch, you know that? Here, this is the bounty I put on her
He's
head.
He's gonna skull fuck Violet's head.
That's two psychopaths dead. If you can bring down the third, there's a bonus in it for you.
All right, I'll go after Cook.
One thing I should tell you about Cook. Piece of shit is pure animal. He raped one of my snipers, and that makes this personal. Also, he's got a flamethrower, and he's damn good with it. From what I hear, he either rapes or burns every living thing he gets his hands on. Only one man's gotten close to killing him, and that's Little Buster. So he says, anyway. Maybe it's bullshit, but I'd still ask him about it.
Who's Little Buster?
Bounty hunter. Talks big. But he's still alive, so he can't be completely full of shit. I think he's out in the yard waiting to claim a couple bounties.
Got it.
You've gone after the fiends before. I don't have to tell you to keep alert. Good luck.
Goodbye.
Right.
And over here on the other neutral blip, we can go find Little Buster. Was a little bitch.
Yep, I'm still here. Shit, I got nothing better to do, right?
Major Daughtry said I should ask you about Cook.
The rapist with the flamethrower? Yeah, that's a combination I stay the fuck away from. I was stalking him for a while. Real good at that. Watching people from where they can't see me, you know? Only one thing I learned about that asshole. Keeps a bunch of Brahmins. Most of them he roasts whenever he feels like it. But there's one. Must be his pet or some shit. Doesn't let anybody near that Brahmin. Somebody puts a bullet in her, I bet that piss him off good. Might make him careless, too.
Goodbye.
Hey, yeah. Next time you see me, maybe I'll be rolling in a shitload of caps, right?
Yeah, see, that guy's kind of an idiot. Alright, so do I have to be outside to trigger this one? Must be. I don't know, let's take down some dog meat though. And he's actually not far from where we just were. So let's go have a look over there.
Of your own.
And of course, once again, we don't take him in the head. Throw it in his chest. Where is it going to do anything? And he's still alive. Thank you for that. You're gonna stop practicing and blow something up in this game. I don't know, I think I sold off all my grenades. How are we doing, Ron? I know I reached out to you today because I hadn't seen you for a while. I wanted to make sure you didn't get Ruby Ridged. Because that would blow. And I can use that metal armor to go and fix up my helmet for whatever reason that I can't figure out. the census takers are chasing me. I may have to relocate to Ruby. Nice. And if we step over here for a second. Now we've got another map location and someplace else to actually go into a little bit. There's a vault in there that I do want to go and check out here in a bit. But this isn't the vault that I have up in the title. We'll do some drugs as long as we're here. Make up some drugs. And the veggies. At some point here, I should go back to the big mountain and see if I can make up a bunch more stim packs. I didn't do one in 1990, 2000, or 2010, so why start now? I have no representation in this corrupt government. I did mine in 2010. That was the first one I actually participated in. Because in 2000, I was still 16 and still counted for my parents. Well, I can guarantee you I didn't do one in 1980 because I wasn't alive. I hadn't been born yet in 1980. 1984. This is not the government agent I'm looking for. All right, Dodger, you prick, where are you? There you are.
Still working on that last bounty?
I want to claim a bounty.
If that's true, that'd be the last of them. Yeah, that's Cook. Did he always smell like this, even before he was dead? And the fiends let this guy touch their food? Well, this is payback for at least one of my troopers. She'll be glad to know he's dead. Here's your caps. You've been one hell of a stroke of good luck, you know that? Those three scumbags probably killed 20 NCR troopers. And you bring them down alone. Wish I had a few grunts as good as you. Damn good working with you.
Sir? Alright, that's another one here. Let's go load something else up. I want to see where this is, because I've never done this before. Alright, let's check this out. Kind of curious about this. Over here, there's apparently a drop box. Like I say, I don't particularly care for the Legion, but if they're gonna give me shit for free. Until I go apeshit and start shooting at them. Well, what do you know? Oh my god, look at all that stuff. I never knew that was there. That is awesome. This one, because we're going to be going right by one of these guys in just a bit. So we'll do talent pool. This is where I want to be, is Vault 11. That's what I wanted to do tonight, was Vault 11. So, we'll start from the gas station. Man, that was a whole bunch of stuff. Did you guys see that? Like, I'm actually going to have to go sell some shit before I go into this vault. Why there's a lone mercenary walking around with a gun out. I don't get that entirely. Let's see what old Lady Gibson's got for money. That'll be an interesting one to find. She's sleeping now. Well, we can take care of that. How do you figure you have no representation in this corrupt government? They do everything that the people want, as long as the people live in New York and California.
So, you're back. Now, where did we leave off?
Show me what you have for sale.
Happy to do it.
She'll normally just keep junk around, but yeah, you know, once in a while you'll get the stuff to upgrade stuff. And Stimpaks. Kinda wanna play with this a little bit. Cause I've never really done that either. I'm gonna play with the flamer. I know, I don't mean I'm gonna go to Madison when I say that. Because I can go to Madison and play with a lot of flamers, but I don't really swing that way. I don't know if you're picking up what I'm saying there, but... What? Okay, well that works. At least I've got a monitor up. I just scrolled the chat back up again, where I can't see it. God damn it. It's okay, my tablet's going. I can still see what you guys are saying.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Can you repair shit? No, because you can't go full repair. That's lame, because there's only like two people in the game that can do that. And one of them is in DLC. I forgot that she's repair capped.
Take care.
$257. Not as low as I wanted to get, but it's something. So, go straight ahead, I guess. That's my dog. Straight ahead where there's a camp in front of a billboard. And over here where there are ants. The ants have been busy because they took down a pack Brahmin, too. Steal a little bit of shit out of there. Mercenaries trip clean. The pack Brahmin still got shit on there. The Lonesome Drifter.
Howdy, little lady.
Tommy Torini at the Tops is looking for musical acts, if you're interested.
Maybe it's time to give these tired old bones a rest. All right, show me what you've got.
I'm giving you a real opportunity here. How about some compensation?
I suppose it's only right you get a little something for your troubles. Here, my daddy left me this gun. Guess I don't need it no more.
Oh, bam. Now I have the Mysterious Magnum. A unique 357 revolver, I believe. No, it's a 44 revolver. And when you draw it... it plays the Mysterious Stranger sound from the original Fallout. Wonder if that means that this guy's the Mysterious Stranger. Alright. As long as I'm here, we're gonna go clean out this vault. So we'll hit the dry lake bed, and then we will hit the vault. Vault 11. That will be the third vault that we've done in this game. Because now we've done 37 and 22. I hate ants. So did I catch the lake bed? Yeah, I got the lake bed. Another map marker down. At which point we come up here and find the completely optional vault that doesn't have an in-game quest tied to it. Vault 11. First things first. Going back to the submachine gun. Here. Because I'm better with those than I am with a single shot.
Here we go. Here we go.
Hey, here we go. And if I really wanted to, I could seal us in. The vault is sealed. Nobody in, nobody out. For 200 years. So all the vaults have an experiment going on with them. And the experiment in Vault 11 was some sort of political experiment. I'm still not 100% sure how it went, because I haven't seen enough of the lore. But as we find terminals, we will be exploring the lore of this one. Security recording, vault entrance. Say there's plenty of munitions. And we have animal friends, so the giant rats don't fuck with us. Cool, thank you for that. Appears to be the doctor's office, where they died on the table.
Huh. What's going on?
Pretty sure the dog is having a field day is what's going on. Take those weapons. Bone saw, not so much. But I will take those knives.
Mm-hmm.
Haley is a known adulterer and communist sympathizer. Elect Haley for overseer. Glover has done nothing wrong. Vote for Stone. The latrines lasted. It appears the dog has found something to be pissed about.
What's going on?
Vault 11 Election Guide. Dear fellow Vault Dweller, congratulations, your dedication to the democratic process is the bedrock upon which the continued stability of Vault 11 is based. Now, to help you make your decision for this year's election, the Coalition of Vault 11 Voting Blocks has put together this Handy Dweller's official guide to obtaining overseers democratically, or D-O-G-O-O-D, that contains a summary of the leading candidates for overseer, as well as their statements, key positions, and most importantly, endorsements. Sincerely, Ray Gottlieb, Chairman, Coalition of Vault 11 Voting Blocks, President Justice Block, Candidate Henry Glover, Endorsements, Utilitarian Block, Divine Will Block, Allied Service Workers Block, I'm a devoted husband and father of six beautiful children. My oldest, Sam, was on the honor roll this quarter, and I couldn't be prouder of him. My youngest, Henry Jr., just said his first word, and it was Dada. Well, we've got this bond already, and he's still just a baby. Friends, when you go to the polls this election, I want you to think of your own children. Then I want you to think of Stan and Henry Jr. Picture their faces. Nate Stone should be overseer, not me. Candidate Donna Haley. Endorsements, Human Dignity Block, United Vault Technicians Block. I'm aware of the rumor circulating around me. I want everyone to know that they are vicious lies being spread by the other candidates in a desperate smear campaign. I've never in my life done anything so depraved, let alone for such things, but even if I had, that still wouldn't mean you should vote for me. Consider the facts that are that I am grossly underqualified for the position, and that both of my opponents are far more deserving. I know nothing about governance. You would be hard-pressed to find a worse candidate than me. I can promise you my administration would be a disaster. Wow, this sounds a lot like our modern election system right now. Candidate Nathan Stone, endorsements, Justice Block. This is ridiculous. I shouldn't even be a candidate, and I wouldn't be if it weren't for all the dirty backroom politics going on around here. It's sickening. You should all be ashamed. Notice of postponement. Fellow citizens, due to the tragic events of the past few days, the Coalition of Vault 11 Voting Blocks has unanimously decided to postpone the election for overseer pending further investigation into the murders. Your security team wishes you to know that they are still working tirelessly day and night to find the perpetrator and are already following up on a number of promising leads. God willing, if the killer is apprehended swiftly, we may have found a promising new candidate for the overseer. Sincerely, Terry Hart, President, Human Dignity Block. Overseer Order 745. Effective immediately, the traditional selection process for overseer is hereby ended. In lieu of a yearly election, a citizen will be chosen 1 month prior to the start of his or her term, with our mainframe's random number generator ensuring complete impartiality and fairness. Karen Stone, or Catherine Stone, rather, overseer. So, they're having the election to become the overseer, but it appears nobody wants to be the overseer. And as we find more lore, we will figure out why, I'm guessing. Let's see where this goes. Man, I tell you right now, bolts will drive you nuts because they all look the same. Exactly the same as you go along. And they very much are a huge maze. Alright. Those are all the same. We've read all those already. Got him. Wait, you're not reading current news? Yeah, no. I mean, that seems a little bit like what that is everybody standing back and telling everybody how terrible they are. I can't figure out what universe we're in where somebody thought that an 80-year-old man with Alzheimer's is fit to be the president. Can't wrap my head around that one, I'm sorry. It's probably wrong of me to say, but... So we went that way. Another terminal there. Ow, you fucking prick. It's a good thing I have 25 doctor's bags. Alright, same stuff. There, Ron, I blew something up. Did you see it? All right, living area.
Shit.
mini nuke. Now, why in God's name would you keep something like that inside of a place where people are living in close quarters to each other and can't get out? That seem odd to anybody else? Joe Biden has lost loved ones. What the hell? We all have lost loved ones. It's part of the human condition. I caught some of the DNC. It was pitter-patty show. Oh, yeah, I didn't watch any of it. I did some of the transcripts this morning, but no. There's no information there. I'm a political wonk, and I can't do it. There's another mini nuke around here, is there? No, but there are grenades. And if there are 25mm grenades, then somewhere around here, bet you, there's a grenade launcher. I don't know, it's been a while since I've been in this vault, so. Alright, so we read all these here, but we've also got a deposition on this one, so let's see what that's got to say. Excerpt from the deposition of the defendant, Catherine Stone, by Vault Attorney Gerard Miles. Okay, let's pick up where we left off, Kate. Catherine. Sorry, right, Catherine, I keep forgetting. My husband calls me Kate. You were telling us of a discussion you allegedly had with Roy Gottlieb of the Justice Block. Not allegedly, had. We've been through this. It's still just your word against his, Miss Stone, but please, the discussion. He said my husband's name had come up in their meetings, the candidate endorsement meetings. Yes, they were going to endorse him. He wouldn't say why, but I know my husband had a regular poker game with some of them, and he'd been on a winning streak lately. And according to you, what did Mr. Gottlieb offer? He said he would sway his block, prevent the endorsement, but only if you perform sexual favors? Yes. Was this just for Mr. Gottlieb? No, all the block leadership, they're friends, and you agreed. What else could I do? They had a majority. How long did this go on before the endorsements came out? I don't know, a month, maybe. And when they came out, you and your husband was endorsed despite your supposed agreement. Was that when you decided to kill members of the block? Yes, I thought their majority is pretty slim. If I thin things out a little, especially in the leadership, someone else might get elected. Assuming you weren't caught. No, Mr. Miles, I expected to be caught. That was my best chance. Now they'll elect me. A confessed murderer? You think voters would be willing to risk putting you in charge? They have to pick somebody and live with their reasons. Yes, but wait and see. So this is something where they don't seem to want to be elected. Once again, much like Biden picking Harris. take more of those grenades, though. There's got to be a grenade launcher around here somewhere if they're going to keep throwing those at me. A grenade machine gun, if you will. Dorms quick before I go down to the overseer's office. And there we'll get a jumpsuit. Perfect.
Nothing here, I guess.
Sarah's gonna want one of those. Personal one. That was easy. Vote for Joe, let your mind go. Oh yes, this year 2020 must be working. Better oneself, start your own business, develop new skills. This is the only proper way to have more money. Going to get a snack. Didn't watch any of the DNC poop show tonight. Those people are disconnected in reality. Security recording. Downloading. Four corpses at the front entrance of Vault 11 and strange recording point to sinister events. Determine what happened to the citizens of Vault 11.
Are we really gonna do this? It's open. We could just leave.
I couldn't. Not after that.
We don't deserve to leave. A shining example. That's what it called us. But we were. We did what we were supposed to. Not by a long shot. Anybody would have done what we did.
You ask me? That's exactly the problem. Now let's get on with this.
I'll go first. Wait. People should know what happened. They could learn from it. If there's anyone out there at all, I hope they never have to find out. Ready, Harry?
Yeah.
No! Wait!
So, somebody shot somebody. Of that much we can be certain. Imagine living like this for 75 years, which is what they initially said, that all the Vault's experiments were supposed to be 75 years. Just in a little vault like this. Mike was whining about poor people living in a multi-million dollar home and a fat bank account. Bernie's speech last night seemed like she was making a pitch to be made Joe's Secretary of State.
Well, we must make sure that the government knows what they are going to do. And I will make the government into the government that I want it to be.
Alright, how the fuck do I get out of here? There it is. What's on this side? May have to go clean out before I go further in. I've already been over encumbered once. Tell you this, there isn't a lock that's going to stop me for long. So now we've got two security recordings. I've already done the one recording.
She can't do this.
It's done. We're done.
Nothing's done.
She's got the authority. The only thing she can't do is change her own fate. Nothing says she can't change the selection process for future overseers.
I say she can't.
You shouldn't have toyed with her like that, Roy.
We still have the majority.
We don't vote for anything anymore.
I'm not talking about voting.
What then? You want to have a sit-in? A hunger strike?
Not exactly.
Maybe march into her office with torches and pitchforks?
Yes.
Come on.
I mean it.
What? Start a revolution?
Laws don't outlast their governments.
Roy, all we have to do is wait until someone from Justice Block gets picked for overseer. Then we have them change the law back.
There won't be any blocks after the new overseer is picked tomorrow. Everyone's going to move on. By the time we've reformed, who knows if we'll still be in the majority?
We can hold the block together.
You don't know that. Besides, what if the computer picks you? What if it picks me?
And your solution is to start shooting?
Not if you don't have to. Look, we arm up. We go to the lower floors, take some strategic targets.
Power, food, water. Companions here.
Just until she turns authority over to us.
The other one is
not carrying anything at all.
They're tired of us having the power.
We have the majority. We don't need them.
This isn't a vote, Roy. They'll fight back.
They've never had the nerve.
Hell of a way to test it.
Thank you. There, that'll free up some room. Alright, now I don't have to go unload. Yeah, I don't know. I'll read the transcripts in the morning, but I mean, it's all predictable at this point, and I honestly don't care about what the DNC is doing anymore. They're trying to lose at this point. I can't see any other way forward for them. I don't know what their angle is, but they can't be trying to win. There's no way. Let's grab the other recording here. Oh. Nope, just a password. So we listen to the recording. Heard people start shooting. Overseer's office, we've got a rigged shotgun that either completely missed me or didn't do a damn thing. Need a key to get to the Overseer's terminal. Arcade, you better watch where you're pointing that thing. Okay, I have no idea what just fucking one-hitted me. We might have to go and find out. Let's go snag that as long as we're in here again. Terminal's locked. Filing cabinet's empty. Alright, I guess let's go figure out what the hell one hit at me.
What's going on?
Thank you. guessing that plasma grenade bouquet that just dropped over there was what one-hitted me. That's interesting. Also booby-trapped. So it appears that we had a war zone going on in here at some point. Differential pressure controller, what is that for? If I remember correctly, that is for something. It is a quest item. Saving here. Looks like the game might be getting ready to start glitching. And look, more rats. Rats and more stuff. I'll take that because I can make ammo out of it. So Vault 11 is flooded throughout the majority of its area. Now we did some searching underneath the water a bit ago. Boy, they sure do have a lot of defenses before getting into the reactor. Where's this go? This, of course, is the conference room where we were looking down into from the overseer's office, right up there. Well, how did I get here? Collapsed tunnel, another terminal. Prepared speech of Gus Olson. Ombudsman. Prepared speech of Gus Olsman, Ombudsman for the annual overseer election. Good afternoon. Each year it is the appointed task of each of the ombudsmen not only to officiate the election but to chronicle it in hopes that after the last overseer has finished his term and walked to his death in the chamber beneath the office, and that the vault has become still, that one day some excavator from humanity, or perhaps some yet unknown race of super beings, might find our records and incorporate them in historical canon. But lately it's occurred to me that that's not really why. I think the real reason we do it is because we want to believe that somewhere in the archives there's an answer to all this, or perhaps there will be one when the historical records are completed and the whole story is told. We want it to make sense, to understand why the vault's mainframe will kill us if we do not offer one of our own as a yearly sacrifice, to fully comprehend why we continue to have these elections despite the unfettered corruption that has plagued it for what must be decades now. There was a simpler time when elections meant shaking hands and kissing babies, but now, with the rise of the voting blocks and this infestation of bribery, drug trafficking, smuggling, and God knows what else, we want to know why. Well, I've been through the archives, and I can tell you, you won't find the answer there. You'll find an account of the first overseer, who entered the vault as the only citizen aware of the sacrifices that would have to take place, but he didn't have the answers either. If he did, surely he would have foreseen the citizens' anger when he broke the news. Surely he would have guessed that they would want to choose a sacrifice democratically, and the way that we citizens are accustomed to washing our hands of this terrible deeds. And that his name would be at the top of the polls, and that the simultaneous vacancy of the overseer and martyr would forever fuse the two positions here in Vault 11. But he didn't. He had the answers no more than any of us, and the records state that after the citizens discovered that the sacrificial chamber's password was his wife Betty's first name, and its door was unsealed so he could be offered as the first sacrifice, he walked down that room crying like a child. I can only wonder if there are no answers to be found, and we're just going along with this because we don't see another choice. Nevertheless, I still hold on to hope that we can find one. I urge you all to take the journey I took, to remember that it wasn't so long ago. We were ruled by our civility and our dignity, and that those were times when we didn't have to be quite so ashamed. Thank you. So apparently, the experiment of this vault was the fact that every year they had to choose a sacrificial lamb to go into a sacrifice chamber, and they decided that it was going to be the overseer every year. So let's go check out the rest of this. take a prepared speech of Gus Olson, ombudsman for the annual overseer election. Let's listen to it, I guess. Oh, no, it's just going to give me a written transcript, which I already had. I do think there had to be something else going on here, because otherwise they probably wouldn't just mine the entrance to the kitchen. Maybe they would. Cool place to get stuff if we need it. Yeah, there was definitely a war that happened in here. I think they just kind of killed each other. Is what it appears. Alright, let's come back down into here. Down in the reactor, we've got even more carnage and bodies and bunkers. It does appear I've been here before. Yeah, this is what we have for this vault. But I believe I got the password now, so let's go and take the rest of it, I guess. It does kind of look like they all just killed each other, doesn't it? All right, open sacrificial chamber. You knew it was going to be under the desk. After Fallout 3, you knew it was going to be under the desk.
Congratulations, Martyr. Your fantastic journey is only just beginning. Please proceed to the light. The light is calming and puts your mind at ease. Go to the light. Sit in the chair. The show is about to begin.
All right, we're gonna watch a movie.
Greetings, Martyr, and welcome. If you're here now, it means you've been offered up as a sacrifice so that your vault can continue to thrive. Currently, you may be feeling sad or angry. Perhaps you never got to have grandkids, or to enjoy the pleasures of a fresh cigar. But march with your chin held high, soldier, and remember that each of us has an important role to play. For some people, their role might be to heal the sick. For others, it might mean they will drive a race car, or fly a rocket ship. And some of us are meant to forfeit our lives for the good of the people. Sure, it might not be as fun as driving a race car, but it's every bit as important. Let's take a moment to reflect on the moments that made your life worth living. Think about that time you kissed your steady girl for the first time under the bleachers at the big game, or when you snuck out after curfew to catch that new flick that your parents wouldn't let you see because it was too scary. Boy, were they right. And who could forget when you met the love of your life? What a looker. These are just examples. Do you feel that feeling stirring in your chest as you think of these things? Good. What you are feeling is peace. You've led a great life. Living it has been its own reward. But it is only the beginning. Close your eyes now and imagine what joys await you in the next life. The afterlife. Can you see them? Good.
All right, we're going to put something a little bit more armored on. I feel like I might be cheating because I know what's coming. Or the game is going to soft or hard lock. One of the two. Son of a bitch. Good thing I quick saved right when I did. All right, let's try this again. All right, let's try this again.
The light is calming and puts your mind at ease. Go to the light. Welcome. Please sit in the chair. The show is about to begin. The show requires that you sit in the chair.
All right, we'll do this again.
Greetings, Martyr, and welcome. If you're here now, it means you've been offered up as a sacrifice so that your vault can continue to thrive. Currently, you may be feeling sad or angry. Perhaps you never got to have grandkids or to enjoy the pleasures of a fresh cigar. But march with your chin held high, soldier, and remember that each of us has an important role to play. For some people, their role might be to heal the sick. For others, it might mean they will drive a race car or fly a rocket ship. And some of us are meant to forfeit our lives
to crash
for the good of the people.
The fact that this is a Bethesda game.
It might not be as fun as driving a race car, but it's every bit as important. Let's take a moment to reflect on the moments that made your life worth living. Think about that time you kissed your steady girl for the first time under the bleachers at the big game. Or when you snuck out after curfew to catch that new flick that your parents wouldn't let you see because it was too scary. Boy, were they right. And who could forget when you met the love of your life? What a looker.
No, I haven't
these
put any of the
examples.
Mods on here.
Do you feel that feeling
the stability
stirring
mod?
In your chest as you think of these
so
things?
So memory might have been a part of it,
good.
But pretty much it's
what
a Bethesda game, and that's
peace.
What caused the crash.
You've led a great life. Living it has been its own reward. But
I'm running at
it is only the beginning.
Use right now.
Close your eyes
I may have to close everything and restart.
And
the browser is hogging
joys
a lot of resources
in the
for
next
me.
Life. The
for some reason.
Life.
Well, yeah, browsers do that lately, too. That's something you gotta keep in mind as well. So, what was supposed to happen here to the Overseer, who was chosen through all of this, is that after you watched the video, they were coming out to sacrifice. In a pretty violent fashion, too. Like, there are probably a lot easier ways to do that. But of course, we took care of it all. I guess I do have 100 survival. I didn't think I did. Let's throw a little bit more into barter, just for the hell of it. Let's throw a bit into melee weapons, too. Alright, what else do we got? What else can we do? After this, we've only got 2 of these left. Certified tech, broad daylight, rad absorption, lessons learned, voracious reader. It's getting hard to decide what to actually use for skills as we're running out. Suppose I could take adamantium skeleton. That'll be handy, though. You've learned how to pack mountains of gear for the long haul. Being over-encumbered no longer prevents you from using fast travel. Nope, we're going to use that. As much time as I spend over-encumbered in this game, if I'm outdoors, then I can just head somewhere. I can't believe I didn't know that was there before right now. And we found the mainframe. Override lockdown. System recording, Vault 11 solution. Recording download. Automated response, Vault 11 solution. See what this is.
Congratulations, citizens of Vault 11. You have made the decision not to sacrifice one of your own. You can walk with your head held high, knowing that your commitment to human life is a shining example to us all. And to make that feeling of pride even sweeter, I have some exciting news. Despite what you were led to believe, the population of Vault 11 is not going to be exterminated for its disobedience. Instead, the mechanism to open the main vault door has now been enabled, and you can come and go at your leisure. But not so fast. Be sure to check with your overseer to find out if it's safe to leave. Here at Vault Tech, your safety is our number one priority.
So they found the mainframe, the solution was embedded in there the whole time, and now they can open up the vault.
All right, I know you can hear me, so listen up. There's five of us left. Five out of I don't know how many. So it's over. We've talked and it's over. We're not gonna send anybody to die anymore. So shut off our water, our gases, or do whatever it is you're programmed to do. But we're done listening to you.
And with that, we have cleaned up another vault. Huzzas are in order. Yes, I noticed my Sid Meier Test of Time game is that way sometimes as well. It'll just crash. I think the longer I watch a stream, the resources more resources hogs and does not release. This browser window started off at 64K and now it's almost 400K. 400,000K, yeah, well, 400 megabytes. What are you using for a browser? Because I've noticed that makes a difference. And Chrome is a hog. Chrome is a massive, massive hog, and that's what I use every day. didn't notice the NCR guy in here the first time. That's interesting. But he sure as hell was there. Alright. And that was Vault 11. What are we at? 10:30? Means I've been going at this for about 2 hours now. Let's see. See what's in Novak. I think I know who's there, but let's go see this guy. I think we could almost just finish this one up and.
So I hear. Hey there. Need anything?
Yeah, I could probably unload some stuff with you. You're gonna use a recruit helmet anyway. That's kind of neat. I've never seen a merchant do that. Oh man, guys, this whole getting up early thing is starting to get to me, actually. I'm feeling tired already. Let's do that and get rid of this shit, at least. I mean, as long as the merchant's standing right here. In metal armor with a recruit helmet. That's kind of neat.
Morning.
I didn't want Manny Vargas's room. There's another one here that I wanted. Just gotta think of whose it was. Or I can look at the map.
Oh, it's you.
You're looking for work as a singer. Tommy Tarini is looking for entertainment.
Well, it's no shark club, but I hear security on the strip is real tight. Even Mr. Bishop wouldn't hit a joint like that. I'll check it out. Thanks.
Alright, so it looks like we got one at the Wrangler, so let's go check that out.
looking down at all your smiling faces. That won't last long. This gal's so sharp-eyed. Well, if it isn't my number one fan, what can I do for you, number one fan?
Tommy Torini is hiring new acts at the Tops. I think you could make good money.
Too bad I got this ironclad contract with the Garretts. They'll never let me out of it.
I could go talk to Garrett and try and convince him to let you go.
Huh. Good luck. Garrett's a tough, mean son of a bitch. He's not likely to give up. Let me know if you make any headway.
Yep.
I hear the Legion is camping out across the river. I hope they're not planning to attack. Those bloodthirsty mole rats are never up to any good.
I'd like to get Hadrian out of his contract.
Now why would I want to do that? His performances make me quite a lot of money.
He's not the right fit for this place. You'll find better performers.
I suppose you've got a point. Plenty of Brahmin on the prairie and all that. Fine, I'll cut him loose. He's all yours.
One quick speech check takes care of that.
See ya.
I can go back to fucking a sex robot.
Yeah, go on. Scram. Any luck with Garrett yet?
Garrett's agreed to let you out of your contract. You can go work with the Tops.
Really? You mean I'm finally out of this shithole? That's great. Thank you.
Is one more. But we'll have to go into the strip for it. Let's just cheese a fast travel, I guess.
Strip's not a bad place if you love terrible things and people. I'll never understand the allure of giving. Giving away your money to the rich.
It's hard to sleep in this place, I tell you. Last night, some girl was pounding on my door all night. Finally, I had to let...
You again? You should meet my bookie. You have something in common. Every time I talk to you, I lose caps.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt.
Jeez. You again?
I just have a few questions.
All right, then make it snap.
Tommy Torini at the Tops is hiring entertainers. I could put in a word for you.
Yeah? Hey, you're all right. Tell him I'll do it for 100 a night. No, 50. No, 20. 10.
But you're not supposed to negotiate that direction. Don't sell yourself short. You're worth a lot more than that.
Whoa, geez, what was I thinking? You're right. I gotta go in there with a cool head. Tell them how much I'm really worth.
All right. That takes care of the Tops. Yes, man. We gotta talk to him at some point, too.
Hey, hey, baby doll. Welcome to the Tops Hotel and Casino. I'm gonna have to ask you to hand over any weapons you might be carrying.
Yeah, okay.
Smooth and easy, just the way I like it. Don't worry, they'll be as safe as kittens till you're ready to leave. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, just don't wear them openly. You dig? Now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make your Tops experience the Tops?
Leave me alone.
Have a good time.
I'm getting my fucking guns back. That's what you can do. tired most of the time lately, and if I sit for more than 30 minutes without typing or actively doing something, then I'll be nodding off. Yeah, I don't know. It's just been like this past couple weeks.
Hey, hey, welcome, welcome, welcome to the finest entertainment experience in New Vegas. My name is Tommy Torini, and how can I make your day?
Let's talk about the act I recruited.
Cowboy act? Yeah. He dropped on in here not too long before you. He's got chops, baby, real chops. And I ain't just talking about that mustache. And like we agreed, here's your fee. 5% of the cut comes to 166 caps. Don't spend them all in one place now. Unless it's right here. You talking about Mr. Isaac? Damn, baby, when you bring them in, you bring them in. That cat's gonna bring me money like you wouldn't believe. Here's your 5%, baby. You enjoy that. That comedian, you mean? Yeah. He was a hell of a haggler. Cost me a pretty cap. Hope he's worth it. Here's your 5%. That ugly mug with the razor tongue? Dig it, baby. He'll be one hell of a novelty act, just like Tommy promised. Here's your 5%.
Sounds great.
You know it, baby.
Yeah, that was quite a bit of caps for right in the beginning of the game. Well, like I say, if you didn't play through all the DLC, that's about 700 caps I just made. Quite a bit for a vanilla game.
Take it easy, baby.
You got strip fame for it.
I've heard that elite units are on the way to support our armies here.
Got a couple of the acts already sitting here waiting. It's all good. But I think that's where we're going to call it tonight here. What do we have left? I know we're going through locations like crazy. We'll probably clear out this area the next time we play. I think it'll be about time to do that. Just kind of clear out the center here and do the quests that go along with Black Mountain too, because we haven't done those yet. We should probably also finish out the Brotherhood quest. That's what we're going to do next time. We're going to finish out the Brotherhood quest so we can be done with them. And then we'll go back and talk to Yes Man about that. And get as far down... No, the next time we're going to clear out locations, we'll do the Brotherhood quest and pull locations. And the time after that, we'll go down a little bit more on the main quest. So, we're going to call it there. So I'm about to fall asleep in my chair. Why I saved there. Maybe I thought I was getting done. I don't know. But we are done there, so let's head on out of here. Alright, and that is going to be it for the night here. Thanks everybody who came by and chatted. Wyatt, Ron, and Seawall for coming in and checking us out here. We got some stuff to go over in the morning, I can already tell you that. Looks like the Senate released news on the Russia collusion, but nobody gave a fuck about it anymore. We'll probably read some more transcripts from the DNC, but I anticipate this is going to be a slow news week. And otherwise, we'll talk a bit about what's going on with the post office too, and if people are coming back getting ready to vote for that or not. So, we will be back here in the morning for more contemporary. Otherwise, we'll be back here next week doing some more New Vegas. We're getting to the home stretch. It doesn't seem like it because we've been playing it forever and we still saw all that empty map places up on the screen, but we're getting to the home stretch here. We're getting to that point. So fret not. We will finish this up at some point here. But until then, I am falling asleep as I stand. So I'm going to take that advantage and go ahead and get into bed. We will see you in the morning. Hopefully DLive will have their stuff figured out by that point. And until then, otherwise, we can always get over onto the Twitch and the YouTube. But until tomorrow, I'm Jay Edgar. Have a good night, and thanks for stopping by. Take care.